I mean, the reality of mocap is you're in an extremely unflattering Lycra suit. Like, you're basically in a Velcro suit with, like, little reflective balls, and there's over 80 infrared cameras surrounding you. And you're being recorded from every angle, and there's nothing there but gray. So it's very much about the imagination. But for Destiny, because I had invested thousands of hours into the game, I knew when I got the when I got the call for the audition, I could body match the previous actor's work very well. So it was crazy, and extremely exciting, because what you do for these kinds of situations is you actually do the performance of the body to pre-recorded audio. So the voice actor had already done her job, and so we need to match the movement, the right beats, with the physical performance. And it can be tricky, because you're not given a script beforehand. You arrive there on the day and have to match and learn the script on the fly. But it was super exciting, also because there were some pivotal moments in those cutscenes for the Witch Queen. It's like, oh no, I can't believe this is happening. Oh my God, I can't believe this is happening. Ah! And I can't tell anybody for another year. This is driving me crazy. But I also had a moment when I stepped onto the volume as Eris Morn, and you have a live previs, so you can see your character, a grayed out character, in the space. And they had loaded Eris's character model in, and as she was moving as me, I was like, I'm gonna need a minute. See, there's a little something in my eye. Just a little, I can't. Yeah, I was very passionate about it. I was very excited that I got to be a part of it. It's one of my top moments in my career so far.